episode 2774, it's time to make peace.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy, happy day. I hope you've had a fabulous weekend, and I hope today is off to a great start. But I want you to take a moment. I want you to dig deep in your heart. I want you to search for God. And what I mean by that is shut out all the distractions. It's time to make peace. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. You know, the pressure of problems can paralyze the heart and hinder the mind. It's time to make peace, not with your life, but with God's plans. Oh, how we can become consumed by the doings of the world. The distractions and detours can leave us feeling empty, especially as the fear of the unknowns creeps into our minds. Your circumstances and situations can rock your world for better or for worse. If you're not grounded in God's word and drawn near to Him, it's tempting to become unglued. The unraveling of your days is just beginning. So instead of becoming frustrated and getting angry with your earthly surroundings, it's time to make peace. How quickly, though, we forget that our peace in life is not situationally based. Your circumstances can be devastating, but you still can have peace. Sometimes we just need to hear that. Because a lot of our world, yours, mine, you may have a good friend, our worlds are being shaken up right now. And we are all going through the stuff of life. And we can't compare and say, oh, mine's worse than yours. It's not about that. But we also have to rely on not of our own strength, but of God's strength. What He sees, how He sees it. Yeah, your circumstances can be devastating, but you still can have peace. Not because of what you control in your everyday, but who controls your everyday. And who? Jesus Christ. God's got you. Psalm 91 verse 1 says this, "Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty." How are you choosing to rest today? Now, that doesn't mean you don't have stuff happening, because we all have got stuff happening. But you can decide on how you're going to walk through your everyday. What does it look like? It can calm your heart, right? It's time to make peace. An easy life doesn't dictate whether or not you have peace, right? True peace only comes from God. When you are facing armies of problems, when those problems are coming at you, cry out to God. God's got you. You know, this week has somewhat challenged my patience. My home was literally being shredded because of one water line. And this water line has been a thorn in my side for almost 2 years. But as days turned to weeks into months, all I could do is trust that God had a plan. I didn't know it, but He did. He knew what would happen and how every piece of the puzzle would fit together. You see, this water line disrupted our entire life. It had a ripple effect. Water tends to do that. So instead of me getting so frustrated and caught up, I just had to trust. So I trusted. I let my faith lead my response. Yes, water is great in the shower or outside for vegetation. The grass looks beautiful. Farmers need it for their fields. But inside my home, no more. So as the plumbers took out sections of walls and ceilings in multiple rooms, and let me think, I think it's at least 7 rooms. Maybe it's more now. It was all I could do. And that's just to get to what needs to be taken care of. And that's not talking about any of the destruction that was created along the way. With each ripple of water. It was all I could do. My heart cried out, Lord, I know you hold in your hand the smallest of things. Please hold our home in your hand too. Looking back over the last 600 days, I can see how God has woven everything so precisely and so beautifully. In the moment, I didn't always understand. However, I carried the peace that passes all understanding. So my challenge for you, where do you need God today in your life? Where do you need to release control and let Him weave together His heavenly plans? And remember this, no matter how hard you try, God's way is always better. So exalt what God is doing in your life, even if you don't understand. And it's simple. It really is. All you have to say, Lord, I don't know where you're taking me today, but I know you got me. I'm not going to understand. I may complain. But Lord, know my heart. Know that what I'm doing, I am trying to serve as you see fit. I'm trying to lead my family as you see fit. I'm trying to understand your heavenly plans. I've got God-sized dreams, Lord, but I still want yours to reign. Remember, the peace is not wrapped up in what you're doing, but how He's moving. How is God moving in your life? You got to have faith. It's time to make peace. God's got you. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.